Mama died.
No, she did not.
Okay.
Did you hear Emma die?
I sent her a pop brownie.
Stop.
I wish she would die. She's a cunt.
No. No, she's not either.
Fuck you.
No, you don't wish she would die. What?
You killed my daughter.
Are you going to start again?
That's patricide.
Are you going to start again?
No. But you did, though.
Thank you. If you're going to start again, I'm going to hang up. I'm not going to listen to it.
Listen to what?
I'm not going to listen to it. I'm not going to listen to you say that stuff.
The truth?
Winning?
You're fat and bald.
Back off.
And a murderer.
Back off.
What are you, a mud flap with a picture of the Tasmanian devil on it?
You need to calm your ass down.
Shut up, Yosemite Sam. I'm grieving.
You're what?
I'm grieving.
Relax.
Why do you keep fucking telling me that, bitch?
Because, bitch, you need to relax.
My daughter just died.
Stop it.
My daughter just died. What do you mean, stop it, you fucking bitch?
Stop it. Calm your ass down.
Why?
Because you need to. You did good yesterday.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah, you did.
I took a lot of
pills. You did good when you were talking to me yesterday. Stop calling me bitch. Jesus. Talk normal. Don't hurt yourself. It sounds like you got some butt issues.
That would hurt.
Huh?
That would hurt.
He was hurt. What?
I've been sick.
Baby, you gotta calm down on me.
I keep vomiting.
Why do you keep vomiting?
I don't know. I think it's my doctor's head is my nerves stress level. What?
Okay, well you. That's why I'm trying to keep you calm. You got to calm down on it.
Sorry. Learn it. Help me. It'll feel good.
You're going to be all right. You're going to be all right, baby.
You're
going to be all right.
Sorry. Oh, my God.
Is Victor there?
Yes.
I can taste
him. Don't get you a butt plug.
Lord, my daughter died out of stupid pedophile jokes.
Stop it. Where's Victor at?
I don't know. He's in here, I think. He's in the... I don't know. I'm not looking at anything because I can't see.
You can't see?
No.
I can't see.
I told you my eyesight is being affected by my renal disease, asshole.
Yeah, but you must be able to see something. You called me.
Bitch, I had Victor push the fucking picture of the pedophile. I dialed you.
You need to fucking stop the pedophile bullshit.
Shut up. That's what you is.
No, it is not.
You're
you fucking know it. So stop it.
Shut up.
You call me names, I'll just hang up.
Candyman pumping Lorne's tummy. I don't care about you anymore. You killed my daughter, and I already told the paternity, the district paternity.
Winnie, you gotta keep it up, I'm gonna hang up.
What have you been talking to my sister about? Why is she all happy walking around?
I don't know. I haven't been talking to her about anything.
You've been talking to her about? You don't know what you've been talking to her about?
Winnie, fucking stop.
What?
Stop. I'm not
doing, and why?
Because.
Tell me, bitch. Are you fucking talking to her or not?
See, you fucking call me names and shit this morning. I'm just going to fucking hang up.
No,
I want to have a good fucking conversation with you. Not
then
fucking
tell me then let's have
up
a conversation.
One.
What are you telling my sister?
I haven't told her anything.
You haven't texted her one thing or told her anything, right?
What?
You haven't sent a single text or phone call or anything with her?
I texted with her a little bit, but...
You just told me...
I haven't called her.
Fucking asshole.
I haven't called her. I texted with her a little bit, so what? I haven't called her.
Did you send a picture of your fucking dick? Did you flirt with her?
Shut up. Shut up.
You did.
You gotta fucking stop. You gotta fucking stop.
I hate you so... We're broken.
Stop it.
We're broken up.
You need to fucking stop. Jesus Christ. You're creating fucking drama this morning. Awful. Stop doing that.
Stop trying to fuck my sister, you fucking cunt boy.
Stop it, Winnie.
Stop trying to fuck my sister.
Stop. Fucking 7 o'clock in the morning and you're trying to create fucking problems.
Now, I'm asking you to stop trying to fuck my sister. How is that drama, you fucking bitch?
Well, the drama.
No.
7 o'clock in the fucking morning, I was wanting to have a good conversation with you.
Well, how could you do that when just a few hours ago you were probably having phone sex texts with my sister, bitch? Trying to fucking...
No, I wasn't.
Tell me the truth. Were you or not?
No.
All right.
Jesus, shut the fuck up.
I'm going to call her and ask her.
Go ahead.
I will.
I haven't talked to her since yesterday.
Yeah, right. You probably sent her pictures of your fucking cock, you fucking liar.
Jesus, the fuck's the difference if I did? You fucking sat at the table and went through all the pictures of my cock that I've sent you.
So you think that because I've looked at your penis pictures that you can send them to my sister?
You looked at my penis pictures with your sister.
But you are sending them to her without telling me why.
Winnie, stop it.
Why?
I'm not going to deal with fucking drama this morning.
No, tell me why you're doing this to me. Why are you trying to fuck my fucking sister?
Why I'm doing what? I'm not doing anything.
You just told me that you sent your pictures of your dick to my sister. I didn't think that you were. You really are?
I said, what difference would it make if I did?
You did.
Sat at the table.
Oh,
you sat at the table and you've shown her every picture of my cock that you have.
Oh, my God. So because of that, somebody sent a picture of your cock to your mom. So I'm going to send her the whole folder full of your piss cock. Because it's already been done. It's no problem, right? Yeah.
Will you fucking stop it?
Hey, Mama,
jeez, you're fucking creating
here's
drama.
Your son's elbow macaroni dick.
Stop. You're fucking creating an awful lot of fucking drama for no reason.
You are trying to fuck my sister. You don't think that's a little fucking dramatic after you tried to fuck
you
my
need to fucking stop.
Daughter before you killed her?
You need to fucking stop.
Can't believe you.
You're being fucking stupid this morning. Knock it off.
No, stop trying to fuck my sister. Why? What is stupid about that? Yours are
stop, Winnie. Stop, Winnie.
Why are you doing
stop,
this?
Stop, Winnie.
Why are you doing this?
Winnie.
Why?
Stop.
Why are you doing this to me?
Stop.
Why?
You're fucking creating drama for no goddamn reason.
Why are you doing this to me?
I'm not doing anything. In your head, I'm doing everything.
You're fucking trying to fuck my fucking sister, bitch.
Call me back when you can stop your fucking bullshit. Stop it.
Stop it. Damn! Get down!
Jesus Christ.
Get down!
I don't want to hear that.
But do you remember? That was funny. I had to remind him about. Remember when that happened?
What?
Do you remember when that happened?
Yeah.
It was funny.
Sooner than I was there, I'm quite positive I remember. Why would you keep playing that?
Because you killed my daughter. You deserve it.
You want me to fucking hang up on you again?
No.
Then stop saying that stupid shit.
I don't care.
Well, you need to.
Well, you think my sister loves you? Why don't you be with her?
Winnie, stop.
You be with her. Oh, I have donuts.
The only one that's fucking creating anything is you.
Why don't you go be with her, you fuck?
I'm with you.
Nuts.
I'm with you.
Well, then, are you sending your pictures of your cock or not?
No.
If you're with me, you wouldn't.
Well, what's the matter? What's the matter if I did? You're fucking showing everybody my cock.
That's all right. You said no, so I'll just...
It's my cock, so if I want to fucking show everybody, I'm gonna. Because you already are. Anybody that's fucking seen my cock has seen it from you.
Not 13-year-old Kayla.
Winnie, knock your bullshit off.
I'm gonna show Dan my cunt.
You already have! You fucking did it the other day!
Oh,
did I yell at you? No, you know why? Because it's Dan.
Dan's a man. What are you, excluding his manhood? You should have seen him. Wow.
No. Because Dan's one of my best friends.
No, I don't like
He's
him.
Already seen your pussy anyway.
He hasn't been inside of it yet.
You fucking walked around, prayed around, and... in front of him naked.
So my daughter tried to blow him.
Did you see him? Did you see how much of a fucking fit I threw?
Why, were you talking to my sister then, Taylor?
How'd you go from fucking Dan to your sister?
I just gotta roll over because we have a big boy bed.
What?
Fuck you.
I wish the fuck you'd stop.
I don't see why you're creating so many troubles. You killed my daughter, now you're trying to have sex with my sister. I was just kidding. I can't believe you said you did.
You just fucking told me I killed your daughter again. Don't say it again, because I'm fucking pissed off about it.
I forgave you for killing her, but I'm not going to lie and say you didn't. Okay, but still, though, like, just a little bit you did.
Stop winning.
Okay, a lot, but I'm not saying anything else. Don't you understand? I feel guilty. And I know that it's because I introduced her to you.
I understand.
That she's dead.
You need you need to calm down.
If she never met you, she'd be alive right now. You don't know.
You need to calm down.
I can't. They just tell me.
Please calm down.
I don't know what to tell you.
What you need to do, baby, is you need to calm down.
How's your mom?
What?
How's your mom, stupid?
Oh. She's good. She's having a problem with her hearing.
Oh.
Her hearing's getting worse.
They can get her a hearing aid, baby. They just, like, put a battery in it and it makes everything louder.
She got it. She continues to have it turned up. But she said the other day that she's thinking about getting something, some type of implant or something, put in her ear or something like that.
Oh, that's cool. Like a bionic woman.
Make her hear better.
That'll be awesome.
Yeah, something like that. It would be awesome. It would be nice if she'd be able to hear me. It seems like she can hear me a lot easier than she can hear Roy.
Because you shout.
Well, I didn't think I shout. But maybe I do it because I'm in the truck. And I have to talk louder and make sure people hear me better.
Okay.
Well. Roy's doing good waiting on her.
What's he waiting for?
But in the morning, it's really nice in the morning because she can get up and go sit in her chair, and Roy brings her coffee to her and makes her breakfast for her. And that's all good, but...
Oh, that's sweet.
But when he waits on her too much, it doesn't help her. Because she needs to get up and have the exercise.
Well, she gets tired really fast. She probably gets tired fast, because that's what happens when you get old. I mean, not trying to be mean, but... Yeah.
No, I don't even trying to be mean. It's true. When you get older, you get tired faster.
Yeah, just a little bit of walking's okay. Roy don't have to have her run laps and stuff. I hope he's not doing that.
No, he's waiting. He's waiting on her too much. I told him last weekend that he's waiting on her too much. He needs to let her get up, do things on her own because she's independent anyway. I think it kind of bothers her that Roy's waiting on her so much.
Yeah.
Not used to it. But I told her this summer she needs to get back on the treadmill.
Don't tie her to it.
You're so funny.
Come on, let's let me have a little laugh.
Baby.
Wow.
She agreed to it because she wanted to anyway. She wanted to get on this winter, but she hasn't taken the time to do it, and her shoulder wound up hurting her because
she's not running on her hands.
Weather and her arthritis.
The arthritis gets worse when it's cold, I heard.
Yeah, it does.
That's why
she had the wood stove for so long, because she did. I just got the wood stove, what was it, maybe 5 years ago? She had the wood stove for so long because that wood heat helps the bones a lot more. When you're older and you get arthritis, that wood heat is better for you than any other kind of heat. But since she hasn't had the wood stove, it seems like her arthritis has bothered her more.
You should give it back.
It really bothered her, just a couple weeks ago. I don't even think it's been a couple weeks yet that her arms felt a lot better.
Okay.
Her shoulder and her arm. So that's why she hasn't used the treadmill this winter.
Is Roy drunk?
Nope. He hasn't even touched anything.
Good.
Hasn't touched anything, hasn't thought about anything.
You don't know what he's thinking about.
stupid.
Well, I'm sure he's thinking about. I'm sure he's thinking about it, but he hasn't touched it. He's been doing really, really good.
That's good. How about you? Because you can't drink with your low trimmings.
Yeah, I'm not drinking either.
I wish I could.
No, you don't.
Uh-huh. You don't know what I wish, you fuck.
Well, I know what you. I know you wish you could, but.
Well, God.
But why put it in your mind? It's not in my mind. I'm concentrating on summertime being here and being able to get more done on the house.
Well, I'm dying, so I just want to fucking be drunk, stupid.
Well, concentrating on you coming up here, too.
Yeah, right. You want Debbie to go up there, not me.
Winnie, why do you gotta start that again?
Because I know you want to lick Debbie's puss, probably.
I know you need to stop. I know you need to stop.
Did you tell Debbie you look like a mongoloid?
Did you find anything out yet from stuff you're gonna find out?
What?
Before you come up here?
I have 19 days. Before remember what? Like 4 days ago I said I had 23 days? God.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Well, last time you told me you had 21.
Well, yeah, it needs to be 21 days. I'm not cleared. Fuck.
Well, fuck. Nah. Relax. Fuck.
Stop telling me to relax, you fucking bitch.
Relax. Fuck.
Fuck.
Relax. Fuck.
You sound like a Cadbury bunny.
Yeah, I know.
Easter's
coming up. It happens. Fuck.
Where are you going to hide your eggs?
I'm not hiding them in my pants. You want to get them?
Yeah, if I can boil them first.
No, well, that's not very fucking nice.
Well, baby, nobody wants rotten eggs, right?
Well, these eggs are attached to me.
Well, just soak them in some cyanide like you put my daughter.
Look, you're starting again.
I'm sorry.
Knock it off.
You're so stupid.
Stop. Calm down. What'd you do last night?
I was crying.
Did you watch TV? Did you play a card game with Victor or dominoes or Yahtzee or anything?
No, I took a scalpel and took the toe nail off on my pinky because it was stupid.
Oh. You took a scalpel and what? What the hell are you doing with a scalpel?
I took it from the doctor's drawer.
You shouldn't even have a fucking butter knife, for Christ's sake.
Ugh, they give you one.
Well, yeah, that's because I use it for what it's supposed to be used for.
Well, I had athlete's toenail.
Butter, mayonnaise. You have what?
I had athlete's toenail. I had to dig it out.
Athlete's toenail?
Yeah, it was thick with fungus, so I cut it off like it says on Wikipedia.
Oh, God. Athlete's toenail.
Yes.
It's so funny.
What's so funny, Fungus King? You should know all about that.
You're funny.
Okay, well, I only have 9 toenails, so who's funny now, bitch?
You don't have 9 toenails.
Yes, I do.
Yes, she does.
See?
Take a picture of it. Film me.
All right. Here, Victor.
I was here.
No, I don't want to look at it. It's gross.
Shut up. Fucking do it.
Why would you cut off your toenail? You're not supposed to cut your toenail off.
Because it was black and it was falling off, so I just had to cut a little bit, and then the new one's going to grow back, Dr. Walker said.
Yeah, you cut it back. You didn't cut it all the way off, right?
So? I cut the part that was falling off because it's like a fucked up toenail. It's all thick, and I pulled it off, and then I cut the rest away.
how much of it was black.
It was all black. That's why I took it off, and it peeled right off like fucking watching the fly. And he pulled his ear off.
I know what you're saying. I've had to do that before.
Why do you think I'm lying? It's a dead toenail.
I thought you meant your toenail was healthy and you fucking cut it off.
No, it was scratching me, so I had to take it off.
Oh.
It was flippity, like your tooth.
I know what you're talking about. I've had to do that before.
I put it in a baggie. Victor doesn't want it.
The only reason it's black is because it's blood on the inside.
Oh, it stinks.
That's what that black is. Well, it shouldn't stink. Mine never stunk, because I never smelled it.
Oh, God. It smelled like a Cheeto.
I don't. Your toenail smelled like a Cheeto?
It smelled like an old Cheeto.
You didn't eat it, did you?
No, that would have been fucking cool, right, though. That would have been punk rock. Oh. Victor, where's my toenail?
No, it's gross. Don't say it.
I'm going to chew it.
It's in the bag of Cheetos.
Victor, I need my toenail.
Victor, if you want a Cheeto.
Victor, you want a Cheeto?
No.
Why are you crying?
Leave me alone.
Shut the fuck up.
Hey, be nice to me.
Don't tell me to leave you alone, you fucking bitch.
Leave me alone.
Be nice to him.
Can I please just make you leave me alone?
Shut up.
Wait, hey. Be nice to him.
Can I please go to my apartment now?
No!
I haven't been home for like a week. I'm hungry and I'm tired. I can't sleep because you keep throwing stuff at me.
Shut up, that's what you get, bitch.
Wait, hey. Be nice to him. Buy him something to eat.
Can I please go? I don't got no clean clothes.
Shut up.
I'm tired of walking around without any shoes.
So what?
Why did you sell them?
I needed $5 for the fucking vending machine. I couldn't find my purse.
You sold his shoes?
Yeah. Nobody told him to buy Adidas.
What the hell did you do that for?
They weren't even real Adidas.
So, that bitch paid me like they were.
They had a fourth stripe, stupid.
So I put fucking white out on it. Shut up, Victor!
Why do you do fucked up things?
Because I don't want him to go home.
She won't let me go.
Winnie, you might let him go back to his apartment so he can take a shower. Otherwise, he's going to start stinking. You're going to smell him.
My cat already died because I didn't feed her for a week. I told Winnie, and Winnie says she don't care.
Well, Victor, you need to go back to your apartment. You go back to your apartment, even if she says no.
She says she'll kill herself, Lorne.
Winnie, you better knock it off.
I will. I'll kill myself. Don't you fucking walk out of the hospital. What's more important, me or the cat?
It's you, but you gotta
knock it off, Winnie.
Stop telling me that. You wouldn't even let me use the phone to call the landlord to give her tunas.
So?
Winnie.
What?
Victor, you got your own phone. You can call the landlord if you want to.
She smashed it.
Shut up. Stop it.
What the hell do you do that for, Winnie?
I don't know why she did it.
Shut up. We gotta go now, Lauren.
No.
No, please, Winnie.
Don't tell him shut up. Start being Abe, Winnie.
I don't know what the status of Abe is to be.
You need to behave. Treat him better than what you're treating him. He's there for you.
I wanna go home, please, so I can at least bury Molly.
No, she's gonna fucking rot. Above ground or underground. Stay here with me.
I know I want to stay here with you because I'm your friend, but I just gotta get away from this place for a little bit.
If I can't, you can't. Now shut up.
Okay.
Winnie, he can too. You don't own him.
Yeah, I do.
Nuh-uh.
Oh, you don't.
Yeah.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah,
he's got to do what he's got to do, Wendy. You got to let him take care of the business that he's got to take care of.
He doesn't have any business.
I just wanted to feed my cat. That's all I wanted to do. I was going to come right back.
No, she don't need to eat, bitch.
Yeah, she does, Wendy. Shut up. Let him go home and feed his cat, take a shower, and change his clothes.
Lauren, please call my landlord. Please call my landlord. 503-782.
Hi.
Well.
Are you okay, honey?
No way. No way.
Okay, well, I'll just stay calm. Don't want you to get all worked up. I know. You get a hard time right now.
Why do people think I'm dumb? Like, I don't know it.
You don't know what?
About anything.
Like what? What are you talking about, honey?
Everybody thinks I'm dumb just because I'm in the hospital.
Baby, what are you talking about?
I'm not stupid.
What are you talking about?
Huh?
Who thinks you're dumb?
You.
Why do you say that?
And Victor left, and he isn't coming back, I guess. He told him to go.
He's what?
Victor's not coming back.
Why?
Because I hurt his penis, and he says it hurts.
Why are you even touching his penis?
I didn't touch it to have fun.
It doesn't matter. That's his penis. Leave it alone.
Well,
it's not yours to play with. That's his toy.
It's not a toy. It was what I was using.
What was you using it for?
To something control him. Supposed to?
Well, that is not for you to do.
Why not?
Because he is not for you to control. You need to treat him better. He's been there for you. He's been there because he loves you, because you're his friend.
He wants to leave me. Nobody wants to be here with me.
Baby, all he wanted to do was go home and feed his cat, take a shower, and change his clothes. Then he was going to come back.
Yeah, it was my fault that the cat was murdered.
Listen, just never mind the cat. Right. When he wants to go home, let him go home so he can shower and take care of the stuff that he needs to take care of.
But he's mine. I own him.
No, you do not own him.
Don't yell at me.
Don't own anybody. Well, I'm not yelling, honey. I'm sorry. I'm not yelling. You don't own anybody. Nobody owns anybody.
Okay.
He is your friend. He wants to be there for you. But he doesn't want to be treated badly either.
I don't want to treat him badly. He just deserves it.
I know you don't. I know you don't want to treat him badly, but he doesn't deserve it. He's been treated badly enough in his life. He doesn't deserve it. I know you don't want to treat him badly. Have they been giving you your schizo pills? Because it doesn't sound like they have.
No.
Why haven't they?
They said I'm depressed and they don't want to throw off my chemical balance more.
Well, they need to give you your schizo pills.
I know.
Not having them just makes you more depressed.
I don't know what to do. I can't think.
You can't think? Did you call Debbie and see if Debbie can talk to him?
All she does is giggle.
Is what?
Giggle.
Gimble?
Giggle. What's all gibble? She does is laugh.
Oh, giggle. What's she laughing about?
I don't know. Everywhere she goes, she's like skipping and smiling. She's grabbing her tits randomly.
What the hell is she doing that for?
I don't know. Fuck up.
Maybe she had a good date the other night.
Wow.
I mean, she went to a ball game or something like that, didn't she? She had some date or something?
Oh, no.
Well, listen, baby. I'm going to tell you what I think you need to do, because Debbie did a good job last time that you let her take control of yourself. I think you need to let her take control of it so that way she can get them to get you what you need. Because you can't do it from in there.
Yeah, I can.
I'm not talking about illegal shit.
I don't care what you're talking about.
Well, that's the problem. You need to care. You need to care, because this is what's getting you in trouble. You want to do all this illegal stuff.
What am I doing this
fuck
illegal
the fucking
stupid?
Drugs.
Drugs?
Fuck the drugs.
What?
You don't need to be calling GT to bring you in any drugs and any of that shit.
That
got you in trouble last time. You can't handle things from in there the way that they're supposed to be handled. She can get out and talk to people and get things done for you. She did a good job of it last time.
You were telling me she was evil and controlling and a bitch.
That was a long time ago. That was when I didn't know her all that well and wasn't real trusting of her, because she was just wanting to come in and take control. And I was like, wait a minute. Well, me, Dan, and Emma all felt the same. He was like, wait a minute, you fucking come in from nowhere. We had you for like 6 months all to ourselves, and we didn't even know about Debbie.
So
she came in and took you out of that rehab.
What are you doing? I don't even know what you're talking
because
about.
Because we know her now.
I've known her my whole life, stupid.
Well, yeah, but you never even mentioned her to me, Dan, and Emma.
So?
You never even told me you had a sister.
So nobody knows until I have a sister. Until
she came in, took you out of that rehab, put you in a house. But we know her now. Calm down, honey. I really think you ought to let Debbie take control of things and get the stuff that you need, because they're not getting you your schizo pills, and you need them. When you don't have them, you're more depressed.
I got you back. I can't stop crying.
Just calm down. Hi, baby. You okay?
Yeah.
Baby, you gotta get control of yourself, okay?
I don't know how to
breathe.
I'm not doing anything. I can't think about anything except for my dead daughter.
Well, first of all, you need to stop saying dead daughter.
Well, you want me to say that she is?
Hey, you're getting all wound up, honey. Don't get wound up, okay? Don't say things that are gonna make you hurt more. Okay?
Uh.
Stay calm, okay?
Why?
Because I want you to stay calm. I don't want you getting all wound up. Stay calm, you're able to deal with it better. You need to call Victor and have and don't hang up until I'm done talking, okay?
I can't call him. The phone, I broke it.
Oh, you broke his phone?
Yeah.
What about his work? Because he lives right where he works, right?
Yeah, but they fired him because they didn't let him go to work.
crap.
He said it's my fault. It's not.
Well, just relax, relax. Hopefully he'll come back. Hopefully he'll come back and sit with you. Well, cross the fingers and hope he comes back. What's that noise?
I don't know, maybe it's pills. You know what everything sounds like.
Okay, you blowing your nose?
Yes.
Smart ass. Yeah, I knew what that sound was, didn't I?
I stole some cat.
Let's calm down, honey, okay?
Cigarette outside. I don't care anymore.
Do what? What'd you say, baby?
I stole candy and I'm smoking a cigarette outside.
Well, you don't steal. You know better than that.
Yeah, I just did, stupid.
Well, stop doing things you're not supposed to do. You know you're not supposed to do something, don't do it.
It causes
more problems. It just causes more problems. You don't need to deal with stupid problems right now. Okay?
Okay.
I love you, baby. You're going to be all right, honey. You're going to be all right.
I want to be dead.
No. Don't talk like that. Don't talk like that.
Hey, look at that sunshine. Fucking Debbie.
Why are you saying that?
Because she's walking around saying, knocking on sunshine, looking at her phone.
Maybe she's got the song Walking on Sunshine on her phone. Who cares? Just let her do what she's doing. Just concentrate on getting, on calming yourself down.
I don't want it. I don't care.
Hey. Don't have spurts like that. You don't need to do that. You need to stay calm.
King Kong.
King Kong? I said calm, not calm.
I don't feel like King Kong. I feel like a little ant.
All of us do compared to King Kong.
So hard not to make a joke about your mom.
No. No, it's not hard.
Yeah.
No, that's not hard. My mom is too good of a person to make jokes about.
Why did my daughter have to die?
Baby, that might have been out of everybody's hand. It might have been God.
I hate God. Been God saying,
no, you don't. No, you don't. Because that's where she's at now, is with God. Only she's an angel. You know damn well she's an angel.
Angels are only men.
No.
There's no angels in the Bible. That's what the deacon told me.
Well, I don't believe that. I only think of angels. And if that's the case, why is it that all the angels that are made, most of them are female?
They're not. The Bible never says anything about that.
You look in the Bible and there's a picture of an angel and she's a female.
What do you think? God drew it? There's only male angels in the Bible.
Well, you need to look at in the Bible again. There's a picture in there of an angel, and it's a female.
Shut up. Can you call Uncle Clayton, ask him if there are any female angels, please, in the Bible?
No, how about we just look in the Bible?
I looked at the... God!
Baby. Hey, honey, listen, I will look when I get home, okay? Or I'll call the pastor of the church and ask him.
Okay.
Or actually, you get a phone right there, you can look right on the phone and ask Google. Are there any female angels? In the Bible, does it say that there's any female angels? I can guarantee you there is. You need to send me a picture of Rhoda. I'll draw a picture of her for you.
I can't.
Bless you, honey. Okay. Send me a picture of Rhoda, and I'm going to draw a picture of Rhoda as an angel with wings.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. I'll look through my phone right now.
Okay. You got to take a deep breath on me, okay? I'm probably not going to be home till like 7 or 8 o'clock. Well, I don't know. It's quarter to three now. So another 2 hours up there, 1 hour down there, half hour home, 2, 3. Yeah, it'll be 7 or 8 o'clock before I get home. I'm going to have to speed at some point, too, because I only got 5 hours left that I can drive. So it's going to be close. I love you, baby.
I wish I could die.
I wish I could hold you right now. What are you wearing, baby?
A dirty white shirt. Sweatpants.
A dirty white shirt and sweatpants?
Yeah.
I bet you look beautiful. I bet you look beautiful.
Look like a shit twat.
No, you don't. I'm hoping Victor will come back over and stay with you tonight. He does. Let's be there for you.
I don't want her to be dead anymore. I want to do voodoo or something. Now her body's too burnt.
Hang on, baby. I'm in a little bit of a bad area. Get up here and I'll be able to get my signal back better. Okay, what did you say?
I want to do voodoo to her to make her alive or make her body come into another body like Victor died in T.O.A.
Your body do another what?
Like I could get a kitten or a bird or a fish and Victor's T.O. will put her soul in it. I can hug something that's alive.
Oh, you can't hug a fish, honey.
Well,
you can, but it'd be rather difficult. Baby. Why don't you get a kitten?
I'll name it Rotor. I'll let Victor T.O. You don't think it's weird?
No. It's not weird at all. It makes sense. It makes a lot of sense. I don't know if they'll let you have it in the hospital, though.
I'll go ahead and tell Victor to let his T.O. call me then after he comes back.
Just make sure Victor's T.O. isn't going to say that Rhoda has to give up her soul to be in the cab. That's not going to happen.
Well, she can't give it up. They put it in there for her, like the Mormon.
Yeah, but her soul actually belongs to God. Everybody's soul that believes in Jesus, their soul belongs to God.
There is no Jesus.
Their soul goes to God. You believe in God, honey? You do, because you wanted to accept Jesus into your heart before, and we did it. Me and you did it. So you do believe in God. Ask Victor Teal if he can put Rhoda's being in the cat.
Her pee?
Her being.
That's what it is.
Not peeing, being. With a B.
That's what I'm going to ask for. It's what they said.
Okay.
They can bless Matt and Rhoda's name, and it'll be like a hugger.
Okay. But remember, you gotta treat the cat good, because the cat will actually be Rhoda.
I know. I want it to be Rhoda. I want to love something again.
I know. Okay, honey. Calm down,
not
baby.
To be mean, but I don't want just you. I want Rhoda back.
I know, baby. I want her back too, okay?
Okay. I don't like it out here.
I know, baby. I know. I know, baby. It's going to take a while, maybe, but it'll get easier.
Did you hear that?
Did I what?
Did you hear it?
I won't go that way, I won't go this way. Did I hear what? What, baby?
This is the traditional King James Version of the Bible featuring the 66 books of the New and Old Testament feature only males as angels. The Archangel Gabriel and other males who appeared to people in their own human forms were all male. There is no record of a female angel in heaven, as they cannot.
Oh, they can't. They can, and they do.
I'm reading it.
That's the King James Version, baby. That's the King James Version.
That's the Bible.
Get the New Testament. Or the Old Testament.
That is the New Testament. King James Version.
Right, hey.
The Old Testament,
calm down,
and
baby.
New Testament together comprised of the 66 Bibles. The 66 books of the Bible. My Peter and Paul and Ringo.
Okay, baby, listen to me. Regardless of what the Bible says, there's no way in hell that I believe that there aren't any female angels. I believe there's more female angels than there are male angels. Because females are extremely special.
I'm going to go take a nap.
I think it's a good idea, honey. Do you want me to stay on the phone with you?
have to take a dump first.
Huh?
I have to take a dump first.
Okay, well, you don't need me on the phone to take a dump.
Okay.
When you lay down, take a nap. When you lay down, take a
nap. Yep.
How do I say this?
What?
Me and Debbie are pretty hard on each other.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How did that happen?
Well, I'm not sure myself. But it's actually only been like a couple of days now that I've realized how hot she is for me, and she sent me a picture of her without her face, just her body. And yeah. I'm like, holy fuck! But see, the thing with me is that Debbie sent me a picture of actually her, and it's taking how long for Winnie to send me a picture of her, and I couldn't even get the real picture of Winnie from Winnie. It came from Emma.
Really?
Yeah. You remember when you and Emma were here that night?
Yeah.
And I told them, I said, I've never really gotten a real picture of Winnie. And Emma apologized to me, and she said, I'm sorry. She said, I thought she had sent you a picture by now. And I said, no. I said, can you send me one? She said, yeah, I'll find one, and I'll send it to you. And Emma said, the next day, Emma sent it to me. And Winnie's beautiful. Winnie's completely fucking beautiful, and it pisses me off.
Yes, she is.
I haven't seen a picture of Debbie's face yet. But Debbie sent me a picture of her body. You know, and that's more than what Winnie did.
You've seen Winnie.
Yeah, I've seen Winnie. I've seen pictures of Winnie. A few pictures. The only pictures I've seen of Winnie are the ones that Debbie sent me, or the ones that Emma sent me. Those are the only pictures that I've ever gotten of Winnie.
Maybe Winnie wants you to like her for her personality. Before,
yeah, but after over a year,
it could happen.
I've loved Winnie up and down for over a year now.
Let me love you up and down.
And this thing with Rhoda happening makes it more difficult because I do love Winnie. I am in love with Winnie.
So,
and I can't just let Winnie go like that.
So are you just going through the motions with Winnie at this point, and you really don't?
I really don't want to be with Winnie anymore. Because of the way she acts, I can't live with that the rest of my life. There's no way I can live without the rest of my life. You've seen the way she acts.
Yeah.
It's not kosher.
So if you and Debbie, you know, forgive me for asking, because I don't know how far along this has gone. Have you guys engaged in any hanky-panky or anything?
Well, me and Debbie have had phone sex before, but that was a while ago. That was before now.
Oh, really?
And now, yeah, now it's like we both know how we both feel about each other.
Right.
And it's more serious than what it was before. And now I gotta fucking talk to Debbie because I gotta tell her, well, because Debbie's been skipping and hopping around and shit and singing, I'm on Sunshine or some shit like that. Songs.
Oh, yeah. That song, I'm on Sunshine. Yeah.
Yeah, and telling, so Winnie, I know something you don't know, and all that shit. And I got to tell Debbie not to do that because I don't want Winnie hurting. And if Debbie does shit like that, then I'll turn right around and I'll be right back with Winnie. And you know, I'll phone Winnie because I don't want Winnie hurting. She's hurting enough. I don't want her. I mean, she's had a hard enough life.
She has had a hard knock life, but she needs your support more than anything right now, Lorne.
I know. That's why I'm trying to hide the shit with me and Debbie. That's why I got to talk to Debbie and tell Debbie she needs to cool her jets around Winnie.
You're trying to creep and keep it on the down low?
Yeah. Because last thing that I want on earth that I want to do is hurt Winnie. And I mean, and if Winnie is able to come up here, and then Winnie's going to come up here because, I mean, Winnie's not doing good. She's...
It's tough.
I'm really confused about what to do, and I guess I'm confiding in you because I want you and Emma to talk and be able to talk to me about it because
I know that
I can't be in a fucked up position.
I know that there's a verse in the Bible, I believe it's Galatians, where they speak about don't go chasing waterfalls. And stick to the rivers and the lakes that you're used to.
Yeah, I'm used to Winnie, but the problem is I'm not used to Winnie fucking going off the handle.
Right.
And Winnie constantly goes off the handle. And I'm not used to that, and I can't have that.
Well, you need...
Especially in my position.
Maybe you need to support her a little bit more so she can grab a hold of that handle. Tightly.
Yeah, but that's not me, though. Because as much as I support her, she still goes against the grain.
How does she go against the grain?
Look at what she did with Victor. Look at what she does with Emma. I mean, I fucking tell her that Emma is my best friend. She still treats Emma like shit. It pisses me right the fuck off.
I think we made a breakthrough tonight. Listen... Both me and you confronted her. We told her to treat Victor better, and she opened up her heart and wallet to him.
Yeah, with me and you on the phone.
That's right.
Telling her to do it. We shouldn't be have to tell her to do it. She's 31.
Well, maybe for right now.
Almost 32.
Well, maybe right now, for right now, if we can... Help guide her down that primrose path, and she will stop and smell the flowers.
Maybe, but I doubt it. It's been a fucking year. She hasn't smelled the flowers yet. And I am really into Debbie too.
What is it that Debbie makes you feel?
Normal.
Normal. Explain that. I don't know what that means.
Like what you and Emma have?
Okay.
Normal. Normal.
What does Winnie make you feel?
On edge. All the fucking time.
Have you tried talking to her?
Yeah, many, many times. And you've been there on a lot of the fucking conversations. I have feelings for Debbie, and I'm not going to hide them, except for to Winnie. I have to hide them to Winnie. Especially right now with Rhoda dying.
When is the last time you've said to Winnie... I love you unconditionally.
I told her today that I love her.
Unconditionally.
Unconditionally,
Lorne. Whether she acts up or not, you say, you know what? I love you.
Yeah, but it's obvious that I love her unconditionally because I put up with it for so long. You know exactly what I'm saying because you've had to deal with some of it, with right. a lot of it, a lot of the time. So you know exactly what I'm saying. I'm not going to live my life having to deal with that kind of bullshit all through my life. Winnie knows that. I've told her that before. I've told her that many times before. But she still does it, and I'm not in a position where I can deal with that, and not wind up back in prison. So that's why I've told her so many fucking times. You can't act like that. You can't do that shit. Stop doing that shit. Now, why are you doing stupid shit? I mean. That fucking pill? She never should have had that fucking pill. She brought that fucking pill from California without them knowing that she had that fucking pill. How the hell did she fucking do that? That's cyanide. That's the kind of fucking pill that needs to be, a very close eye needs to be kept on that fucking shit. So how the hell did she ever get away with fucking bringing it from California to Florida?
Well, I know she was close to death. So... someone must have given it to her.
Somebody fucked up bad.
I agree. Someone fucked up bad. Now, what does Debbie say about what Winnie's going through?
I haven't gotten the chance to talk to her about it.
So what do you and Debbie talk about?
We're actually just now realizing now how much we like each other.
Oh. So she likes you too?
Yeah.
Okay. I can see that. Okay.
And she mentioned your name in a text.
She did.
And you pulled some strings and was able to get her into a place, into a party or some shit like that.
Well, see, that's the kind of guy I am. I call her to talk to her. She tells me to fuck off and hangs up on me and then texts me for favors, and I still come through for her. So I don't know.
Okay.
What?
So I'll straighten Debbie's ass out on that. But you watch. Debbie won't do that. Won't act like that to you again. But Winning, if it was Winning, Winning would act like that to you again.
All right, why don't we make a deal? You let your nuts hang as far as Debbie, and you put her in her place, and I'm going to put Winnie in her place.
All right. Some reason that Winnie listens to you now, she don't listen to me.
And it seems like the opposite. It seems like at least Debbie talks to you. And she won't even listen to me anymore. For some reason, she's pissed at me, but still likes the favors. So, you know who got her those Guns N' Roses tickets? Me.
I don't know. I don't know anything about Guns N' Roses.
Backstage passes and everything.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
See, I don't know anything about that. Because that was before I started talking to Debbie more. So that's why I don't know anything about it. But I'll talk to Debbie and tell her no more fucking treating Dan like he's second class.
I think that she's still pissed at me because she feels like I took your side in the whole conservatorship thing and...
Really?
Yeah. That's not funny.
Her fucking tune is changing now. Oh, Jesus. That's fucked up.
That's not
this whole fucking thing is fucked up, man, is it?
Yeah. I mean, I was just trying to talk to her for you, and now she seems to hate me, but she seems to love you now. So I don't get it.
Okay, well, I'll straighten her out. I'll tell her. Whatever you do, do not treat Dan and Emma badly. Okay. Because they're my best friends.
What if she doesn't listen?
Well, she's going to have to. I'll tell her, I'll say, you're going to treat Dan and Emma badly. I went through that with Wendy. I'm not going to go through that again.
All right, good.
Me, you, and Emma, if I can stuck together like fucking glue.
All right, if you can give her an attitude adjustment, that would be very good.
I'll give her an attitude adjustment. It might take a minute, and it might take a little bit of talking to make her understand.
Now, what
I'll give her I'll give her an attitude adjustment. Because for some reason, she really... You know, she's been watching my fucking YouTube videos.
Really?
Yeah. And I asked her, I said, how often do you watch my videos? Her reply, what the hell was her reply? Something like fucking, I'm not going to answer that. Now my face is turning red.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's fucking, I said, huh. I guess you must have been watching them for a while. Well, because the other day, she told me that whatever I tell you doesn't go beyond you. It can go to Emma, but doesn't go beyond you and Emma.
No, okay? I won't even tell Emma. We boys.
Okay. The other day, she told me that when she watched my cooking show and the knife ran across my glass cutter, that it made her nipples say, hi, sir.
Wow.
Yeah, that's what I said. Like, huh?
Dang.
Oh, because of the knife running across a fucking cutter?
Oh, jeez.
Holy fuck. Can you imagine what I can do with a fucking spatula?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. I had to laugh at that. That was like fucking funny.
Seems like that one's into kitchen utensils, huh?
Yeah, evidently. Let me see if we got a spoon so I can spoon her.
Yeah. Do you ever imagine what you could do with an egg beater?
Holy fuck. Jesus Christ, Dan. I can get a whole lot of yelling going on.
Next time you go down to that auction, see if they got a lot of kitchen utensils.
I can get a whole lot of fucking going on. Oh, shit. I tell you, Dan, I love you and Emma Rich fucking death.
Well, we feel the same way. It's just, you know, and I know Emma feels the same way. It's just that, you know, she can't deal with some of the bullshit from Winnie, you know?
I know. And, you know, it's to the point now where I can't.
And she tells me that she missed time, but...
Me and Emma have dealt with it for the same amount of time with Winnie. The same bullshit for the same amount of time, because it was Emma that found Winnie. Well, because I gave Emma my password, so she go in and check my fucking my YouTube account and shit, and she read what was in the comments things there, the private comments things, and that's when he was Casey, and Emma told me that Casey Morrow sent me a message,
mm-hmm.
and that's when it all started with Winnie. Because when he was actually Casey at the time. So there was like a whole lot of fucking shit that went on there that you know, while it was fucking months, I don't know how many fucking months, that when he was actually Casey. But then when she finally came out with the fucking truth, which Emma found out the fucking truth, because she went to Casey Morrow's studio when he was in the fucking hospital. And Casey Morrow was in her studio and when he was in the hospital. And that's when Emma confronted Winnie. And we still fucking hung on to Winnie and let Winnie fucking, you know, we gave Winnie the benefit of the doubt. Because Winnie said that she really did fall in love with me.
Right.
I was like, okay, well, she really fell in love with me. Okay, there's no reason I can't give her a chance. Well, look at the fucking chances I've given her.
Well,
along the way, fucking Debbie came in, and I hated fucking Debbie before. I fucking hated her.
Why?
Because it was me, you, Emma, and Winnie. And that's all me and Emma and you and Winnie knew was me, you, Emma, and Winnie. We didn't know Debbie. None of us fucking knew Debbie. None of us trusted her. Winnie never told us that she had a sister. So it's like, you know, you're stepping into a fucking territory that's for me, Dan, Emma, and Winnie. The fuck are you doing here? Don't fucking step into the territory the way you're not welcome, because we don't fucking know you. We don't trust you. Because we're talking about Winnie. We're fucking, Debbie took Winnie out of the rehab and had her do the fucking home thing.
Well, in all fairness,
the home thing didn't turn out so good.
Yeah, but
they're all failures.
Well, in all fairness, that, you know, we're stepping in Debbie's territory because she has known Winnie longer than us, so.
Yeah, but we didn't know that.
Right.
So every one of us was protective of Winnie because we didn't know Debbie.
No, that's right. You're right.
And so, but I was like, now we know Debbie, but Winnie's still just constantly fucking up and even fucking up even worse. I mean, she's treating people worse. She's fucking up worse. I mean, I tell you, Dale, I'm so fucking mad about fucking Rhoda dying.
I was very sad.
I'm so fucking pissed off about that.
You shouldn't.
I love Winnie right to fucking death, but this goddamn fucking bullshit of Winnie fucking won the pity party.
Well, her daughter died, Lorne. I don't know if it was a pity party.
And no, but I mean the fucking month of being 3 weeks of being in the hospital, fucking while she was doing drugs.
Right.
That was making her out of it.
Think of how you would feel if your mom died and someone accused you of throwing yourself a pity party.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is those 3 weeks. Winnie told me those 3 weeks she was getting attention. So she continued to play like she was out of it while she was actually being fed drugs. And that fucking kill pill. That fucking die with dignity fucking pill was the fucking thing of pity. And I'm so fucking pissed. She never should have had that pill. There's no, I don't understand how it could be any way possible that a hospital could allow her to fucking leave with that fucking pill. That's a dead pill.
Well, yeah.
Now Rhoda's dead because of that fucking pill.
It's tough to.
I never knew anything about that pill. So Rhoda fucking got into some Winnie's shit one night, and she saw an empty packet. The pill was out of it. The pill was not in the fucking packet. And I was like, all right, well, Winnie must have flushed it because she decided she didn't want to fucking commit suicide. She wanted to flush it. And I never gave it a fucking thought after. And when Rhoda fucking asked me if she could have a bite of the pot browning, I said, yeah, you can have the bite of your mother's pot browning. It's not going to hurt you. I didn't know she was going to eat the whole fucking thing. I didn't know that fucking pill was inside that fucking brownie. And I told Winnie, why would you put the fucking... And she knew that Rhoda wanted a bite of the fucking brownie. And she knew Rhoda went through her fucking purse.
Well, I certainly don't think
Why would you give somebody that's so irresponsible with pills a death pill?
Well, I truly believe that if Winnie ever thought that Rhoda would eat the brownie, she never would have put the pill in the brownie.
Yeah, but that pill did not belong out of the packet. Until it was going to be used, that pill did not belong out of the packet.
Did you know that Rhoda was allergic to chocolate?
No.
She told me when she was staying with me for those 3 days, me and Emma. She told me that I offered her some chocolate, and she said that she was allergic to it. So I think that's why Winnie put the pill in the brownie, because she knew that Rhoda couldn't eat the brownie. So it was shocking to Winnie when she ate the brownie, because she told us that she got deathly ill if she ever had chocolate.
Well, why would Rhoda ask me if she could have a bite of the brownie?
Well, that's the thing. I mean, we can't ask Rhoda that. So I don't know why she asked you that. Maybe she was asking her father figure, for permission.
Something he didn't know.
Yeah, I mean, there's just so many unanswered questions. I mean, I don't know if that's true. All I'm going off is what Rhoda told me. She told me she was allergic to chocolate. That's all I know.
That fucking girl.
So I'm trying to just let you know that I don't think that Winnie would ever put her daughter in any kind of danger. I mean, the last place.
I don't think she would either.
The safe. What I'm trying to say is, in Winnie's mind, the safest place for the die with dignity, or the kill pill.
I don't think Winnie would either.
Would be in a piece of chocolate. I mean, where else would you put the kill pill but in a piece of chocolate?
The kill pill shouldn't have been out of the fucking packet. Especially with someone like Winnie. It's fucking... I don't know, it's just... God, Rhoda's was fucking special. She's a Mr. Fucking Girl. So fucking sweet, and
now do you feel like you've lost a daughter?
Yeah, I do.
Right. I know.
She fucking called me daddy, fucking God, she fucking melted me fucking to the core.
Did you ever think about
her fucking name?
Did you ever think about having kids, Lorne?
No, yeah, I did a long time ago. The Rhoda came along. God, I wanted to fucking Lorne be such a good dad to her.
I think you would have been a good. I think you would have been a good dad to Rhoda.
I fucking miss her. God, I miss her so much.
I know.
Jesus. Yeah. Fuck, I fucking hate this. Trying not to cry, Dan. I'm sorry.
That's all right. We've all cried. Like I said, there wasn't a dry eye during the service. And I'm sure during the next service, everybody's just going to be overtaken with emotion.
Jesus Christ. I wanted a fucking wall so fucking bad. That was my little girl.
It's all right. It's all right, Lorne.
Oh, fucking A. Trying to collect myself here, Dan.
It's okay.
So fucking hard.
All those dreams. That's okay.
Oh, fuck. All right. All right, I think I'm all right to talk now. Is someone there?
Yeah, she's in the shower right now. Well, like it says in Matthew 5:4, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted.
Uh-huh.
You will be comforted, Lorne.
Me, I care about fucking Jesus. God, that fucking girl fucking really touched me.
It is the power of Jesus Christ that heals the brokenhearted and binds up all the wounds.
No, fuck. I'm telling you.
It's not easy for any of us. If you feel you need to cry...
Well, I fucking hate it.
Cry.
I hate being alone, my little girl.
I know. We all miss our little girl.
That girl just touched me so fucking fast and it's fucking it's fucked right up.
And she really took to you, just like a dad.
Yeah, and I took to her fast, too. It's fucking... Oh, I'm so fucking pissed.
I think that you would have been the perfect mentor for Rhoda. All the stuff that you could have taught her.
Fuck.
There's just no words that can really say to comfort somebody with the loss of a child like that.
Fuck.
Are you going to be okay, Lorne?
Yeah, because I haven't punched the fucking wall.
You punched the wall?
No, I said I have not punched the wall.
Oh. If you were going to punch the wall, which wall would it be?
Well, probably the door to the pantry right now. Because it's the closest thing, and I hadn't... Oh,
the door next to the refrigerator?
Yeah. Jesus. How could she be fucking gone?
Yeah, she's gone. I mean, I saw the body. So, but it was a service. Now, did Roy know Rhoda at all?
As far as I knew, no. But Winnie said that Roy and Winnie had conversations.
Oh, okay.
And evidently, Rhoda pretended to be older than what she was, or something. Or I don't know. I don't know what the fuck was in the conversation. I don't even know if there was even a conversation of Winnie was fucking filling me full of shit.
She's
done that so many fucking times.
I remember before I met Rhoda, about a month before, I remember getting a call from Winnie's phone and somebody saying, you know, "Hi, it's Winnie." And I knew it wasn't Winnie. So I was like, this is fucked up. And Winnie confronted her about it, and it found out that it was Rhoda playing games.
Yeah, well,
but that's what
that wouldn't be the first time, because
right, that's what kids do.
Rhoda pretended to be Debbie one time, talking to me.
She did?
Yeah.
Hmm.
I thought I was talking to Debbie because Rhoda was in the hospital and said she had to whisper because she was in the waiting room.
Oh.
And I thought it was Debbie, because she used Debbie's phone. So when it rang on my phone, it came up as Debbie. So I thought I was talking to Debbie. And that was before all this last couple of days of me and Debbie.
So you and Debbie have been pretty hot and heavy for, what, a couple days now, you're saying?
Yeah, well, we're getting there.
But we want to keep it from Winnie because I don't want Winnie hurt.
You think you're going to cross the finish line? Or?
I don't know. Do I want to? Fucking right.
I mean, I'm surprised that you told me you and Debbie are having hanky-panky because she texted me the other day and asked me to get her into that fancy place where, and I guess she had a date or something, so, you know.
Well, she probably does. It's like, whatever. I'm just fucking going a little forward right now. See, but now with this new information, I hear this fancy place that you're into. I hear you have a date for that. So, which is something that she didn't tell me.
Right.
So, I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. I know I still love Winnie. I'm in love with Winnie. And I do love Debbie, too.
Oh, you love Debbie.
I do. I love her.
Hmm.
But Winnie, had more time on Winnie. And I mean, when you're going through a lot of things, but when he keeps lying and pulling shit. And,
now, do you think that...
I can't have it in my life.
Do you think that Debbie loves you?
I don't know. Don't even want to guess.
Now, are you willing to throw away what you have with Winnie to be with Debbie?
I don't know, because what I have with Winnie is a lie, too. Because she can't tell the truth.
How is it a lie?
She can't tell the truth.
Tell the truth about what?
Anything. She can't tell the truth about anything. She keeps pulling this fucking shit and wrapping a fucking string around Victor's dick and all this kind of shit.
Well,
you know, I cannot live with that the rest of my life. I won't live with that the rest of my life.
In all fairness, Lorne, better the floss was wrapped around Victor's dick than your dick.
Oh, well, yeah, but that's not good when it's wrapped around anybody's dick.
No, I get it. But if it's going to happen, better it happened to the next guy than you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but it's better that it doesn't happen at all.
No, I get that. But if it's going to happen, if it has
to... Well, yeah, it's better that than it happened to someone else than me. But still, I mean, Victor's only 20 years old. He don't need that shit happening to him either.
No, of course he doesn't.
That shit that fucking... she needs to stop. She knows she needs to stop. She hasn't stopped in a year.
You know,
a year so fucking time. She still hasn't fucking stopped though.
You know, if I'm at a party with 100 people and someone walks in with a gun and says, someone has to die, I would rather it be someone other than me, of course. You know?
Well, yeah. Yeah, me too. But I don't know.
I mean, I got a lot to live for, you know?
Yeah. I got a lot to think about. Fucking difficult.
I wouldn't give, if I was you, I wouldn't give up on Winnie just yet.
I'm trying not to.
I know it's tough, but if you give up on Winnie now, you might spend the rest of your life thinking what could have been.
I know. And I know how loving she is.
Do you,
it's like, don't want her to be just loving to me. I want her to be loving to everyone.
What if a month from now, she comes through all this bullshit and she straightens her life up, and by that time, you've already broken it off with her, Do you really want her to find happiness with another man?
I know.
I mean, can you...
I think about that a lot, too.
I mean, let's face it. I mean, look at all you've invested in this.
Yeah. And you want an update?
Yeah.
I'm gonna give you an update. Remember how my probation officer gave Emma and you the deadline date?
What?
You remember how my probation officer gave you and Emma the deadline date? You guys have to meet me by this time or I got to cut it off.
Okay.
Well, yesterday or the day before yesterday, she gave me the deadline date with winning. Got to be July or cut it off.
Hmm. Now,
I haven't even told that to Winnie yet because of what she's going through with Rhoda.
But that's really not fair.
Yeah, but at the same time, it's not fair to me that she hasn't showed up. I'm not no fucking lie either.
And furthermore,
fucking bullshit, she hasn't fucking showed up yet.
Okay, but furthermore, probation can't tell somebody who they can be with and who they can't if they're not a felon, you know?
Right, but at the same time, she's trying to push me to get a life away from the people that are from the computer. Because if they can't show up by a certain time, and I've known them for how fucking long, you know, why should I have anything to do with them? It's just a game. And I don't disagree with her. Because it's bullshit.
That's your prerogative, you know. I just think,
After all the bullshit me and Winnie has gone through, it's bullshit that she wouldn't be a fucking show up.
I just think it would be a shame that you prematurely cut this off and always go through the rest of your life wondering what could have been.
Yeah, but she wouldn't be the first one that I've wanted to. She's far from the first one that I've wanted.
How many people have you wondered that about?
Well, three.
Three? Really?
Oh, well, there was Amanda James, which wasn't even Amanda James. She was actually Leslie Miller. It's Paul, Vanessa and Lee Parker, which supposedly was from Virginia, but she had a West Virginia phone number or some fucking shit like that. Then there was another one. I can't remember what the other one was now. So it's not the first time I've gone through it, so. But she wants me to meet somebody in person, face-to-face. Somebody can't be fucking face-to-face with me. They don't want a relationship. They just want to fuck with me. I'm done being fucked with. I'm done fucking around, done being fucked with. You know, somebody wants to be fucking face-to-face with me and love me face-to-face, they need to do it. Because I'm ready to do it for them.
You're ready to make that commitment?
Yeah. That's why this shit with fucking Debbie, at least she's giving me fucking updates. You know, she's fucking... And she doesn't have all these fucking problems that Winnie's fucking had. When them problems wind up being fucking her doing drugs for 3 weeks while she lets everybody believe that she's fucking dying and winds up being that she just wanted the attention.
But in all fairness to Debbie, you don't really know that much about her, and it sounds like...
Nope. Debbie would have time limit, too. I'm done fucking around, too. You know, it's fucking stupid. It never should have been this long with me and Winnie. Ever. It never, ever should have been this long with me and Winnie. It's just a fucking game. I'm just done with the game. You know, if she loves me, she wants me, she can show up.
I mean, I don't think she's playing a game with you, but, I mean, that's my opinion.
No, I didn't think so before either, but, you know, it's just so long a guy can wait before...
It sounds to me...
Before he's going to want to move on anyway.
Sounds to me like this probation officer is filling your head with stuff and, you know, and... Hey, it's your life. I mean, ultimately, you can do what you want to do, of course.
She's wanting me to have a life with someone that I care about, like you and Emma have, face-to-face. Not over the phone, face-to-face. That's what she wants, and that's what I want. I played the over-the-phone game long enough. Dan, let me call you back in 10 minutes. My headset just fucking says about to die.
All right, buddy.
All right, let me call you back in 10 minutes, okay?
Yep.
I hung up. Hello?
Hello, can you hear me?
Hi.
Can you hear me?
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
It looked like restaurant.
No, this isn't a restaurant. This is bowling alley.
Excuse me?
You said this looks like a restaurant. I said, this is not a restaurant. This is a bowling alley.
I thought I had called Lorne.
You did, honey. I'm right here. Smart ass. How you doing?
They gave me a hello.
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Hey, I have. There's a medicine.
They gave you what?
Oh, Victor, I cannot read this.
What?
Come read my doctor's orders, you big stupid ass.
Where?
Oh. Oh. Begin psychotropic
psychotropic.
Okay, what's it do? What does it do?
Fuck, I don't know. Shut up.
Well, it doesn't matter if you tell me the name of it or not. I'm not going to know what it is, but to know what it does.
He's trying to read you the order, you fuck.
Oh, I thought he was... Try to pronounce the name.
Begin 3:31 5:07 a.m. Lithium salt. Lithium.
Lithium.
Yeah. Saroquel.
Circle.
Yeah. Excedrin PRN as needed for a headache. Vicodin, yeah. Oxycontin every 4 hours for pain.
Shut up about that one.
Winnie, you shut up. You don't tell him shut up about stuff that you're taking, because I need to know. Let him tell me everything that you're taking. Go ahead, Victor. Tell me.
Prozac.
Prozac. And don't point to him and tell him not to tell him.
Oh, when he saw you. Oh.
I know you too well, Winnie. Don't point to him and tell him not to tell me.
Won't tell him about this one or which one?
Everyone. Tell me every one of them.
All right. I will kill you.
Winnie, knock it off.
All right.
You don't threaten him again. Remember the talk we had last night with Dan.
All right, here's
no more of that bullshit. All
right, man, shut up. I'm type of psychotic. Saraquel. Antipsychotic. Haldol. And Prolixin. Risperdal.
When I remember the talk I was having with you yesterday about how I think you should let Debbie take control of your stuff again so you can get what you need so you don't get it all fricked up again.
Adderall, Ritalin, and Depakote.
Winning.
And Wellbutrin. And that's it. Those are the antipsychotics, because you're a psychotic. Huh? I know.
Winning. Winning. Winning.
Oh, that hurts. Hey, man.
Winning.
What?
Winning. Winning. Can you hear me?
Yes. Stupid.
All right. Fucking answer, for Christ's sake.
You fucking answer, for Christ's sakes.
I am. All right, remember the talk that I had with you yesterday?
No.
So that you could get your make sure you get your medication and everything that you need?
I got my medication today.
Yeah, well, you need to continue to get it, and they need to stop fucking with you.
Shut up. I got everything I asked for. Depakote, Saraquel, Acrol. Holy shit.
Yeah, but once that's gone... Pay attention. Once that's gone, you need to be able to have it again.
Grandpa!
And again. And again. Stop it. Winning. Listen to me.
They didn't give me Viagra.
I really think that you need to let Debbie take control so she can get things done for you.
What are you talking about? Rhoda's here with me in her bag.
Tell them what you did.
You better not have done anything to Rhoda's ashes.
Just a little bit.
She snorted them with the Ritalin already.
Shut the fuck up.
Winning. God damn it.
It was just a little bit.
You don't touch your ashes again. Whatever container they're in, you leave them in there and you don't touch them.
I sealed it up again with my hair crimper. Well,
you need to stop it. You're disrespecting Rhoda. Stop it.
I couldn't find where the pussy was. God.
Winnie, it's not funny.
I took a lot of stuff. Lauren, she took the drugs after they gave them to her and speeded them out and crushed them and snorted them with my McDonald's straw that I got her with the McGriddle. Stop being such a fucking rat.
Winning.
He needs to...
Jesus Christ. Winnie, you gonna let Debbie take control of your stuff again?
Nobody's going to take control of me, not even you. And if you don't like it, you can take a walk.
You need to let Debbie take control of your stuff again so you don't keep doing this fucked up shit.
Listen here, Tulip. Don't you fucking talk to me like that.
I will snort whoever the fuck I want.
I'm talking to you like that because you need to straighten the fuck up.
I will figure out if I need to straighten
you're the doing, fuck up. You're doing shit that you have never done before.
Why don't you look at your penis and tell it to straighten the fuck up? Because it looks stupid. Like a cheese curl that you would buy.
Well, if it looks so fucking stupid, then why do you want it so bad?
I don't want it. If you want to be like that, you can have it and shove it up your own cock. Oh, that would hurt.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure you really mean that. See, this is another thing I'm saying. Dude, this is how I know you're off the fucking hinge, Winnie.
Alright. I'm taking a lot of drugs.
Yeah, exactly. It's what I'm fucking saying. You need to let Debbie take control of your stuff again so you can get what you need. What? So you can start acting normal again.
I got all I need.
Will you please agree with me on that? Will you please agree with me on that? Because you cannot make your own decisions on this stuff. Shut up and listen to me.
Also some way.
Listen to me. You cannot make your own decisions on this stuff.
Why?
You're not in the frame of mind where you can do it and do it properly. Let Debbie take control of your stuff again.
Okay, look, they put me on new drugs. Look, even Victor.
Yeah.
That
is all the more reason why you need to have her take control of your stuff. Because when you're on these drugs, you don't know what you're saying.
She gave me the phone.
You don't know the decisions that you're making.
Sorry.
So you need to let her take control of your stuff again.
Well, she gave me the phone.
Tell her.
Oh, they said for the first week that she was going to probably feel a little bit funny. Like, they said they really apologized. They were very mad at her because she kept asking for lots of drugs. And they said, like, you can't have this, you can't have that. And they gave her a lot of stuff, though. And they told her that while they're working out her cocktail. Stop, Winnie.
Whatever fucked up shit you're doing, stop it.
A cocktail was gonna make her a little bit feel funny and maybe act a little delusional, and they wanted me to keep a log, not a poop. Like a
log,
journal,
yeah.
A journal and
no, not, not poop.
A journal of her.
A log, it means a record.
Yeah, a urinal.
Write down things, write down things, yeah.
I got a urinal, they gave it to me, They told me to write down any behaviors that I thought were, like, out of the ordinary, and I said, oh, I'm gonna be writing all day.
Yeah, no kidding.
Shut up, you assholes.
Anyway, and they did say for me, and they told Debbie, too, that she was, like, she couldn't wait to, like, get off and tell the doctor to fuck off. Anyway, they told her that, like, we need to tell the people who come and visit her. And then Winnie started crying. Nobody visits me. About, like, she might act a little bit funny and to please don't mind if she is offensive or something. Because, they're going to, like, help her with their thoughts inside the medicines. So?
Winnie, you need to let Debbie take control of your stuff so that she knows what's being given to you.
I want you to take
so that you can, because you can't make these decisions right now. You cannot make these decisions right now. You're not in the frame of mind where you can make these decisions.
Sorry.
You need to let her take control of your stuff so she knows what's being put in you.
How am I supposed to know if that's a good idea if I am not really good at knowing about best interests?
You need to trust me. You need to trust Victor. You need to trust your sister. Because you have done some really fucked up things that I've been questioning for quite a while.
Why?
Because you've the fucked up medicine you've been on, the drugs you've taken before, it's fucked your head right up.
I'm sorry.
You've got to trust us.
I'm not meaning to do it, though. I really don't.
I know you're not meaning to do it, baby. I know.
But you're yelling at
me. You can't help it.
I'm sorry.
You can't. You can't help it because of all the stuff that you've had in you. But you need to trust us. You need to let Debbie take control of your stuff so that she knows what's being put in you. You're not in the frame of mind where you can make decisions like that. You hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, why do I have music blaring in my ear?
Fuck crime. Thought crime.
See?
I have Lorne Armstrong. I'm trying to practice my song for Rhoda's memorial service. I thought you were going to do that too, baby.
I got to write down the words from my phone because Dan texted it to me, so I could write them down. But what time is it going to be? Because I got to go get Roy, and we got to go to Home Depot and get some stuff too, unless there's a closer hardware store open today. I don't know if there is an off.
Thought crime! Fantasy! Thought crime!
Winnie, do you agree with me?
I think we should get married before we do that, please. That way you can be the one in charge. I don't trust Debbie. She's been really weird lately.
I trust Debbie, okay? She knows more about your past. Winnie, listen to me. She grew up with you. She knows more about your past. She knows more about what you're supposed to have and what you're not supposed to have. She is the only one that I really trust completely to make these decisions for you. And she's your sister. She does not want you hurt.
Okay, I will do it. Only, please, if you practice doing the thought crime backup vocals, because Dan's going to do it, but he's asleep, and he can't practice.
I don't know that song.
All you have to do is when I say thought crime, you have to say thought crime just with me.
I got to say thought crime. Why do I need to say thought crime?
Stop, Victor.
What is it? Part of the song?
It's the chorus. It's about this guy who's, in the video, I think it's a priest or somebody who has to be celibate, but there's a really pretty girl who goes to the church, and he, keeps having an imagination of her, they have a kiss under this cherry tree. It's really pretty. That's the video, and, he's talking about the internal struggle of doing what's right and what he promised he would do versus wanting to be in love with the pretty girl.
Desire.
Yeah, that's it.
Versus desire, yeah. I know. I've had that struggle before.
I always have it when I think of you, darling.
it's really sucks having that struggle. It really sucks. It really sucks when you're put in certain positions where, she's fucking, sometimes shit really sucks.
What are you talking about? Like when you make a promise to God that you're going to be celibate, but then you don't realize that you might fall in love?
Yeah, that, and when you make any promise, when I'm not fucking keeping it, it fucking sucks. I hate it when I do it.
Well, I guess that's the internal struggle that everybody has, because we all want other people to like us and to be around us, but we also want to make ourselves happy because we're all a little bit selfish too, but we have to kind of balance those things out. Like, I took the balls off of Victor's dick.
There's other things too where you don't want to see somebody's life destroyed, so you fucking do things that you don't want to do just because they say that if you don't do this, then I'm going to do a certain thing. It fucking sucks.
Yeah.
So in order to get them to go down the right, somewhat right path, you have to fucking do what you go against. Believe them. Warning.
Thought crime! Okay. So I say, thought crime, And thank you.
Spot time.
Yeah. Spy.
You told me to repeat that. You.
Okay.
You told me to repeat that to you. So I'm repeating that to you. Thought crime.
Okay, ready?
Ready.
Thought crime.
Thought crime.
Spies are listening. Thought crime.
Thought crime.
The birds do sing about my thought crime.
Thought crime.
It's annoying because my thought crime.
Thought crime.
Makes me wanna flee. Oh, that was really beautiful, baby.
Thank you, Anning. I've never heard that song before.
it's by Stephen GC.
I've never even heard of him before.
I guess, like, he's this new guy. I don't know. Rhoda likes all that new music. Well, I mean, she used to like it, you know.
Hey. Calm down, honey. Calm down.
I forget.
Hey. Baby, listen. Calm down.
I cried.
Calm down. Calm down.
Okay.
Okay. Give Debbie a call. On three-way.
Now her phone's here charging.
Her phone's charging? Is she there with you?
No, well, she's not in the room.
Okay. Victor, can you go get Debbie?
Yeah.
Winning. Winning.
Please just sing with me. Be careful what you say. Please.
Be careful what you say.
Yes.
I don't know that song, honey. I don't
be
know that song.
Be careful what you say.
I don't know that song.
Be careful what you say.
Okay, hey. Okay, stop. Stop. Winnie, stop.
Please.
Listen to me, okay? Stop singing that song. Stop playing that song.
I have to learn how to sing it before, so I don't cry while I sing it.
Okay, but catch your breath before you start singing it.
Okay.
Catch your breath and calm your mind down. Because if you don't calm your mind down, you're not going to be able to sing it without crying.
Thought crime may twist common sense. Okay. Thought crime may twist common sense. Help me. I can't do it, please.
You're singing it again, and I just asked you to not sing it, so you can calm your mind down.
The only way
if you don't calm your mind down...
Will you listen? I am nervous because I'm afraid I'm going to fuck the song up, and I know that you as a performer understand that practice stops that anxiety. That's what I'm trying to do. If I ruin this, I feel like I'm going to be doing a disservice to Rhoda. I don't want to do that. Will you just please help me? It's going to make me feel better.
Yes, honey, I am trying to help you, but you've got to listen to me. In order for you to do it with not crying, you have got to not sing it for a few minutes and calm your mind down.
I am.
But not when you're playing it right off the bat.
Thought crying.
Give yourself a few minutes and get your breath.
Thought crime, cause your life distress, thought crime, and they could care less, be careful what you say. Okay, That's another thing. I have to say, be careful what you say. And you say, be careful what you say. Okay?
Be careful what you say.
No. Be careful what you say.
Be careful what you say.
Perfect.
Okay, can I eat a pork chop in the meantime?
Yeah.
While we're singing this? Okay, good, because I'm hungry.
May! You're eating a pork chop at 9 a.m. That's great.
I know, I have one left, and I'm hungry. I don't feel like cooking anything. Yeah, it's cold, too.
Thought crime! No matter!
Thought crime!
Yes! Thought crime!
Thought crime!
Done today! Be careful what you say! And you say, you say! Be careful!
You say! Right? Careful what you say.
Yeah, like, I say, be careful what you say. And at the same time, you say, be careful what you say.
Be careful what you say.
Perfect. Oh, that's exactly how Dan will do it. Okay. Careful what you say. Now you say, you say, be careful.
You say.
You have to sing the line with me, like you did.
Well, I'm trying. I don't know when it comes in. I have to go by what you're doing, then I'm winding up being too late.
Okay, when I say go, you and I both say, be careful what you say. But your part is at the end. Your part is at the end where you say, be careful what you say. You say the whole thing, but at the end you go, you say.
Okay.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, go.
Be careful what you say.
Perfect. Better.
Baby, I want you to listen to me.
Okay.
By letting Debbie take control again, you're going to be able to get your head back a lot easier. Because you're not going to have to worry about what's being put down you. Because she knows everything that you're supposed to have.
Oh. Okay.
And she can control all of it. So that way, the doctors know. She'd be able to talk to the doctor so she knows exactly what you're having.
Thought crime!
Thought crime!
Okay, I'll tell her that. Be careful what you say.
Be careful what you say.
Perfect. Oh, God. And I'm going to put that in, like, the way Dan would sing it, because in my head, I would have to make myself sing. Be careful what you say.
Be careful what you say.
That's so good. I like A1 sauce when I eat a piece of meat.
I like ketchup with pork chops, but I got ketchup, but I just don't feel like having any ketchup on it. And Dippy, you can't have my pork chop. You cannot have my pork chop.
I get a steak and I don't want a knife, and I just put my fork in it and eat it like that, like little bites. Do you ever do that?
Yep.
Is that what you did right now? That's cool.
That's what I'm doing with my pork chop. I'm actually using my finger, grabbing my pork chop and taking a bite.
Oh, God, that's like a sexy country boy. Wow. Right, I'm cowboy.
That's more like being lazy because I don't want to fucking wash any more dishes than what I have to, so I just grabbed it with my fingers.
Oh, God, please tell me that you're nude.
No, I'm not. I just got out of the shower. And I put my foot cream on and and get dressed.
Does your foot cream make it feel better, or is it just for the infection?
No, it makes it feel better. I'm actually buying the stuff that costs $15. This is fucking, actually, I should have bought that before because it's fucking, it's thicker and it covers more area and it's more powerful.
So, yeah,
so the Lotrimin Ultra, that's what I'm buying.
It stops you
from... $15 a tube.
It stopped you from having an itchies, like the itchies?
Yeah.
I want some of that because all of this medicine, they told me it'd make me itch.
Yeah, the opiates, they said it would make you itch a lot.
Nobody asked you, bitch!
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, well, opiates do make you itch, I think. I've never had any, but...
Yeah, and Lauren, they said that if she was taking a birth control, that the medicine they would give her would make it not work. And I said, she don't take some birth control because the dude that she is fucking lives in Maine. And she said, that you spray your cums for her all the time and you got a big dick, so it'll probably get her pregnant from here. And the doctor told her it's inappropriate.
I was just making it.
Oh, Jesus.
Cock rhyme!
Cock rhyme! Victor, did you get Debbie?
Oh, I went over and she signed herself out.
So she's not there?
No.
Huh?
No.
Shit.
Usually when she ain't in the room... And she's at the hospital. She's, like, talking to the social service worker or in the cafeteria, like, complaining about the lettuce because it's not crispy or something. Sorry, but it's the truth.
Okay.
She don't like ketchup.
Okay. Winnie. Call Debbie on three-way.
What crime? I told you her phone is here charging, you doofus.
Oh, shit. That's right.
What crime?
Shit, why the hell would she leave without her phone?
I don't know. She did that yesterday for like half an hour. And then she came back with the coffees and a Dunkin' Donut box. And Winnie said I couldn't have one.
And Winnie, you make damn sure that Victor gets two today.
Thought crime!
Thought crime! Thought crime is when... Doofus keeps begging for my pork chop, and I wind up giving it to him.
Oh my God! You're having a
terrible thought crime, Doofus.
Oh my God, Lauren!
Good boy.
You made me smile for the first time in a long time. Stupid! Listen.
What?
I want to do more Lauren thought crimes. That was the best thing you said today. Thought crime. Doofy wants my pork chop. Thought crime! I'm gonna fix my house up! Please do more Lorne thought crimes!
Oh shit, I can fucking... I can get going so I can go get fucking Roy.
Say thought crime! Gotta pick Roy up! Thought crime!
Thought crime! Gonna go pick Roy up! Thought crime! Gonna find some more insulation! Thought crime! Gonna hang some sheetrock! Thought crime, gotta mud and tape it. Or tape and mud it.
Thought crime, gotta give the dogs a biscuit.
This fucking sucks. I can buy a whole roll of fucking insulation to get one, two, I don't know, basically two fucking slots.
Why don't you go to somebody that you know who does work like that and ask if they want to sell you some scraps?
No, I actually got stuff that I can use out in the shed out in Victor's room there and just replace it after, but I had to buy more insulation anyway, but I wouldn't have to buy it today. Wouldn't have to go all the way to Waterville. I don't want to go to fucking Waterville.
Thought crime! Don't want to go to Waterville!
I get a burp. Hang on, I gotta mute it.
Thought crime burp! Thought crime!
Oh, Christ, that weren't a very big burp.
That weren't? Please do thought crime burp.
Thought crime! No, I can't do it. I tried doing it. I couldn't do it. What ain't? Winnie.
What are you doing? That was me moving my chair. I would totally tell you if I farted, and it would be the funniest thing ever.
Well, that's good, but I didn't hear anything.
Now I'm not going to be able to do it again. Thought crime!
Thought crime! All right, now I got a terrible thought crime. Where in the hell is my coffee mug? This is a terrible thought crime.
Say, where's
not good
my...
when I can't find my coffee mug.
Say, where's my coffee mug? Thought crime.
This is a call for war when I can't find my coffee mug.
Winnie, you're so happy right now.
I know. I think singing a song that Rhoda liked is just making me happy. Thought crime.
Thought crime.
My mug.
Okay, I think it's in my car. That's where I think it is.
Thought crime, I think it's in the car. Please.
Phone might get chopped up first. I could go outside here. So hang on.
Thought crime, our phone's gonna get chopped up. Thought crime.
Thought crime. Okay, no more singing thought crime.
Come on, fucker. No, bitch.
Different song.
Thought crime! Sing a different song!
Sing to me.
No.
Live your life.
No.
Like a candle in the wind.
And then I'll leave it alone.
Do what?
Do one more Lorne thought crime, and then I won't make you sing it anymore.
Born thought crime. Oh, Jesus Christ. Fucking water spurted out and fucking jumped the hell out of me.
Do a real one. Thought crime. Lorne Armstrong.
Thought crime.
But you have to finish it. I love it, but you have to say thought crime. Lorne Armstrong's cute. Or something like that. Something cute. I love that.
Thought crime. Victor has something on his poop. It's a thought crime.
I don't.
Oh.
Oh, something cute about you. Like
just thought I'd throw it off there a little bit, Victor.
Like thought crime, you love me.
I do love you.
Will you just say, thought crime, I do love you, then I'll leave you alone.
Thought crime, I do love you.
I love you, sweetie. So beautiful.
I can tell you all of you mean a lot to me.
I want to kiss you now. Thought crime.
Seem to me you live your life like a candle in the wind.
Aww.
Never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in.
Ooh.
I would have liked to have known you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before your legend ever did. Now, that's probably the hardest part to sing to that song, is that part right there.
Really?
Legend
what's hard
ever
about
did.
It?
It's the way I have to move my voice. Sometimes it doesn't come out right. It irritates me. Sometimes it can't get down that low. And sometimes it just doesn't sound right to me. And that bothers me.
Thought crime, it bothers Lorne.
Okay, I gotta go get Roy.
Why can't you talk to me on the phone while you get out there?
Again.
Stop touching yourself in front of me. I'm gonna excuse myself.
I'll go ahead. Get the fuck out of here, stupid.
Winning. Hey, listen. Winning.
Talking to you.
You get enough. Winning.
I wanna
you gotta listen to me, babe.
Listening to your sexiness, and I'm a little bit loopy right now.
I know you're loopy, but you have to show respect for Victor. Okay?
I didn't mean for him to say.
Okay, you gotta show respect for him. You gotta leave. Don't touch yourself when he's there. Don't touch him when he's there. You've got to show respect.
Like a candle in the wind.
All right, where are my keys? Right there. On my hat. All right. All right. And make sure Victor's in the room with you, because when I pick Roy up, I'm going to get off the phone with you really quick, because he doesn't know about Rhoda yet. Okay? Can you hear me? Hello?
Like a candle in the wind. Listen to this, sweetie.
You didn't hear anything I said.
Yes, I heard you about Roy and all that shit. Listen. Can you hear this? It's our baby.
Listen, you get to calm down.
I love your new color. You're so fashionable. Daddy loves you too, you know? I know.
What'd you say, baby?
Rhoda's talking to me, and I'm talking to her. I drew a picture of her on the bag, and it's a good picture, Mommy. I know, it's a good one. Daddy's here. Oh, good. Tell him I love him so much, Mommy. Okay. Baby, Rhoda loves you.
I know. I love her, too, honey.
Daddy loves you. I love Daddy so much. We're a happy family. Hey, Mom and Dad. Ooh, I want some munchos. I used to eat munchos when I had a mouth. That's good you don't have a mouth now, though, because I don't have to share with you.
I can put the phone on you for a minute. Hang on.
I love you, sweetie pie. You're my special guy and mine too. I love you, Rhoda. I love you, Mom. I love you, Daddy. Daddy, come on. I love you, Daddy. Don't leave me hanging. I think he fell asleep, honey. No, He's always trying to sleep. He's a tired.
I had to blow my nose.
Oh.
I love you too, honey.
We're so happy. I like the new cherry Sprite. It's clear. The doctor said I can't have dark syrup sodas, and this cherry Sprite is so good. I wish it came out before I died. That's okay, because you were able to play the games that they would give you the whole game before, like, you'd have to pay for more digital content. Oh, that sounds complicated. That's right.
Okay, I gotta go pick up Roy.
Don't strain your back. Mommy, Daddy can pick Roy up easy. He's strong. That's right, sweetie, but Roy's been living with Mom. Well, that would mean he's fat because she cooks. Oh, Mom!
Do you have Rose Ashes right there with you?
I'm here, Daddy.
Okay, don't open the bag.
I don't
want the bag closed.
Her to squeeze my guts out. I won't, sweetie. Thought crime! Thought crime! Be careful what you say, you say!
Oh, okay. I had to collect myself, baby. I had to collect myself.
I wish they had a Lorne series. I would collect them all. I would collect all of the daddies. There would be new daddy.
Baby, listen to me. Baby, listen to me. Mom's calling me, so hang on, okay?
Okay. That's right.
Oh, shit. Okay, hang on. Okay, can you hear me? No, you can't hear me. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Prime! That was good, Mommy. I know. Thank you, sweetie.
You're welcome.
Oh, you're talking- so funny.
You weren't talking to me.
I was talking to our daughter. Thought crime!
Okay, honey, when Debbie gets back,
I want to talk.
You hear me? Listen to me, please. Oh, shit. Wind blowing that much. I didn't even realize it.
Listen to the wind blow. Watch this.
Okay, honey, listen to me. Listen to me. When Debbie gets there, I want to talk to her, okay?
I will surely do that. Actually, while you were blowing your nose, I wrote something down. Are you ready to hear it?
I'm ready to hear it.
Okay. Hold on. I, Winifred Pollard, bequeath all of my responsibilities, including financial and other personal obligations, to be solely in the hands of the decision maker by the name of Debbie Walker.
Okay.
I am of sound mind and body making this decision for my own good, since I am expecting a change in my ability to make decisions that will be healthy and good for me. Winifred,
That is perfect, baby. That is perfect.
Thank you. Thought crime.
I'm thought crime. I'm proud of you, honey.
Me too. Whoa.
I'm very proud of you for doing that.
Rhodas, why did you summon the bats, huh? I didn't summon them. Saying things. This medicine's great. The 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 medicine's great.
Okay.
The medicine's great.
Honey. Relax. Oh, it's nice to have a day off. It's very nice to have a day off and not have to get up early in the morning, even though I enjoy getting up really early in the morning and relaxing for a couple hours before I go to work. It's just really nice to have a day off where I can do my stuff that
Hi.
I need to do.
Hello?
Hi, I have a package here that's over $5,000. I need 2 signatures.
Oh, where do I sign? Oh, is it from,
Winnie Pollard?
That's me! It's me, Winnie! I got a package. Oh, wow, this is huge. Oh, I know this is. Okay.
Okay, just sign here.
Why do I have to sign it?
It's over $5,000. We have to insure someone.
Oh, for the insurance?
Yes.
Okay. Beep. Okay, there. Thank you.
All right, have a good day.
You too. God, you're hot. Okay.
Yep, baby. Oh,
what's that?
Sorry. I don't know.
You need a crowbar to open it.
No, just get the edge of that chair.
Shit!
Just take... It has the hinge. Ah, God, this is great.
What's great?
What the fuck is it?
Push the button. Just push it. I love you, Mommy.
Whoa!
Wow.
Push it again. I love you, Daddy.
That's great.
Damn. I love you, Rhoda.
Push the button again. See what she says. Chicken wing. Stop recording me, Mom. See, Lord?
That's awesome, baby.
That's cool, but it's kind of creepy.
I paid $8,000 for this puppet.
It's like 3 foot tall, man. It looks just like her.
Yeah, I paid extra so they would make it really fast. Hi, Mommy. I love you, Mommy. I'm so stoned.
Oh, that was a good one.
I don't know. I'm 18. Pizza and brownies? No, I don't like that one. I'll always love you.
How do you make the mouth move?
Put your hand up the back. Tell Dad I said hi. I like that one. Guess which one I pressed for that. I pressed the button over his heart. I mean her heart.
Mm-hmm.
Mom, why are you obsessed with pretty pebbles? Mom, why are you obsessed with pretty pebbles?
I like pretty pebbles a lot, sweetie.
Where are my Donald Duck slippers? Where are my Donald Duck slippers?
I have them, sweetie. All right, where's the back button?
What are you doing?
You're supposed to put her ashes in the doll.
What happens? Why is there a button on my butt?
It's a surprise. Here, push it.
I don't know if I want to call him Prince Daddy or Daddy Prince. I don't know if I want to call him Prince Daddy or Daddy Prince. I don't know if I want to call him Prince Daddy or Daddy Prince.
I had to put it there. That way nobody could see it. Only when she sits on my lap. And then we'd get to talk about her father together. Here. God, they put a lot of fake hair in her head. It's tickling my nose. Here, hold this still for me.
Why don't you put her hair in a clip or something? You're gonna spill it or something. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Bless you.
Oh my god. Clean it up. Oh my god. Just a little bit of rota came out, Lorne, with the sneeze.
It's okay.
Okay, then that's the last time you have to put her ashes in anything, right?
Well,
that's where her ashes are going to go, right?
When I get the cat, I have to mix the ashes with the food.
What?
Victor's T.O. said when I get the cat, I have to mix the ashes up with the food, unless I want him to bless the dummy. He said that would be better. That way I wouldn't get punished for destroying a cat's soul.
Let her do the dummy. Let him do the dummy.
Yeah. But, Cawl!
That way you don't have to move her ashes again.
Why did you snort it some?
Shut up, Victor.
Winnie?
What?
Winnie?
What?
You're not allowed to snort anything anymore.
Listen to me, you goddamn shit. I sneezed some of my daughter on my arm, and I didn't want to throw her away.
You're not throwing her away.
I didn't want to brush her off like she was all dried up semen.
You're not brushing her off. You would be rubbing her in.
I don't want to rub her in.
You would be rubbing her. You would be rubbing her in your... Shut up and listen to me.
I have period blood.
You would be rubbing her in your pores. You would be rubbing her in your pores, so she wouldn't be part of you.
Well, I snorted her in so I can get directly ingested by her.
Well, believe me, you rub her in your pores, she's going to be right inside you anyway.
Okay. Can I rub
She'll absorb into your skin.
So, like, if you lick my pother, I'll be with you forever.
She will absorb into your... But you'll be with me forever anyway.
What if I die?
You're going to be with me forever. Even if you die, you're still going to be with me forever.
Don't worry, Mommy. You're going to be alive forever with me in a dummy. I love you.
The love will always be there. Regardless of anything, even if you and I got married and got divorced, the love would always be there. Once you love somebody, it doesn't go away. It's always there.
Always and forever. Each moment with you. Thought cross.
Get a whole wheelbarrow full of wood here for me. Good. Good, good, good.
Roy has wood for you?
Firewood. Kindling wood.
It sounds hot to me, baby. Or a magnum pot pie, right?
It's wrong kind of wood, dear honey.
Pot crime! It's the wrong kind of wood!
Oh, shit, I forgot to take him home.
Hot fries!
Probably I'll see if Roy wants these. Probably I'll see if he wants these.
Go get him a McGriddle.
Why do I want to get him a McGriddle?
Because they're good. Hot fry me!
Is Debbie back yet?
No. Does it sound like her happy ass is back yet? You don't hear any feet.
No, it doesn't, but... It doesn't sound like she's back, but sometimes I can't hear in the background.
No, Debbie isn't back. Why are you all over her and upset?
What? Roy, I got an 8-pack there of, that lemon-lime drink if you want it. Or it's lime. I don't know if it's lemon or not. Right in the door. Right there. You want to try the grape? Oh, shit of a wreck.
Be careful what you say. Be careful what you say. And that's crime.
Calm down. You're starting to cry. Calm down.
Major, if you make plans.
What? No, it's too windy.
Hot crime!
We'll probably have to do it next weekend if it's not windy. More of it would be exposed to, so.
Okay.
Get more wood in there. Well, just,
be careful what you say.
Roy's phone is whistling at me.
Tell Roy, be careful what you say.
I can't right now. I'm getting wood off his bench here.
Whoa, that sounds so fucking hot.
Oh, yeah.
Thought crime! Be careful what you say. Thought crime!
Roy, where the hell did he go? Thought he went all here.
Hot crime!
When are you going to calm down? I can hear you starting to cry. Calm down.
No, I'm not. I'm trying to help my...
Shit, what the hell was I just going to tell you?
I don't know. Hot crime!
Crap, I hate it when that happens.
Hot crime!
I'm going to talk... Yo, what? How they cut up? Oh, The big ones where?
All drive.
Oh. Yeah, those are...
Should
put them in first, and then... Yeah, well, I didn't want to... You know, you can slide them in... Now, maybe. Before I put the rest of that in there. Shit, I just remembered what I was going to freaking tell you. Oh, I was going to ask you, is Quinn's open today? All right, we can stop by there and get a roll of insulation in. Shit. Fuck, knocked all that kindling wood over.
Be careful what you say.
What?
Be careful what you say.
Crap. Boy, I got half falling out of my arms. Calm down, like a huge son crying. Calm down.
I'm not. I'm trying to do the voice thing that you taught Rhoda. Daddy taught me how to sing. I know, sweetie.
You want me to teach you how to do it?
Take
your finger and put it on your windpipe.
That's what Daddy told me.
No. And shake your finger. Go, and shake your finger. Wiggle your finger right on your windpipe. Hey, where's my cigarette? Hey, go and give Mom a kiss real quick.
Okay, give her a kiss for me too. Oops. Say an extra one from someone special.
Wendy? I'm not Wendy.
Did you go to Wendy's?
Oh, there's Tony.
Did you go to Wendy's?
I went to Tony's. Tony's sister died yesterday, Friday morning.
He did what?
Tony's sister died Friday morning.
Oh, he got a lot of sisters.
She does. There are like freaking 9 kids in this family. 9 or 11. I think it's 9.
9 in his family?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
So what are you doing today?
Going on with a bill and play cards, I guess.
You gonna kick ass? You gonna kick ass and take names, or you gonna stand there and get your ass kicked?
Well,
no, win once and... What was that, heavy or slippery? How much that one cost you? How much did that cost you?
Why, you want to take it with you?
No, I might get one like it. How much did it cost? No, because I don't want one that's gonna.
Huh?
I don't want one that's gonna break on me.
You don't want one to break on
me. I don't want one that's gonna break on me.
Oh, then it
doesn't break on me. Well, I had my other one in there, and that one broke. I didn't think it would. Yeah, but my other one.
Sometimes you can't get a hold of me.
Well, I know, but my other one was like the one you used to have with like that one, and I used that in my truck, and it fell, and the bell stopped working. Well, now how much did it cost you?
$1 or something.
No, it's probably gonna stop. Well, the bell will probably stop working. I'll find something. I'm going to see if I can find a digital one or something, because... No, because it'll wind up breaking. Leave it here where it'll still work. Leave it here where it will still work. Yes, leave it here so it will stay working. If I take it in my truck and go over a bump and it falls out of something and hits the floor, it'll wind up not working. So just leave it here. No, because that's not going to work either. No, that won't work either because my lunchbox is on the floor. So if I go over a bump and it wiggles that around or ruins the bell, no, that it'll do the same thing there. So I'll just give me a digital one somewhere. Don't get mouthy. Me and you, I'll stand your ass up and we'll go toe to toe. Do you see this? You see this knuckle sandwich? Do you see this knuckle sandwich? Do you want a bite of this knuckle sandwich? Do you want a bite of this knuckle sandwich? Yeah, that's what I thought. I know that thing is scary. I know. Alright, I'm going to get you going.
You kissed me once.
I know, I'm giving you another one. I love you. Yeah. Good in you. No, Bill, it's windy out, so I can't have a fire. It's only 9:30. It doesn't get dark now until after 7 o'clock. So, you get out more, you see the daylight. All right. I'll talk to you later. Drive careful when you drive. Bye. I love you. Ready? I got a little bit in the bathroom. Whoops. Here. Oh, shit.
What?
Are you going to see Aunt Sharon?
Huh?
Are you going to see Aunt Sharon?
Am I going to see her?
Yeah.
Tomorrow, probably.
Okay. Maybe I'll go over and see her in the morning.
Tomorrow night, I'll see
you. Okay. Yeah, that's for the access card for the port. I wouldn't think you'd want to stand next to my guy while I got smoke blowing out of him.
No.
Then why are you? I know. She don't bitch you up. That's what I was thinking. She won't bit you up because you can get her coffee and her breakfast. I can't leave that in that because if I leave that in there, I'm going to wind up forgetting. I can't forget that. No, it's going to fall off. And I'll give her a reflection in the window. I got tipsy. A little bit. Not bad.
A little bit bad.
Thank you. Your phone keeps whistling at me. Oh, shit. We can go over to Quinn's. We'll go up around. Yeah.
Just
of having all your wood back here.
Yeah.
Now's the time people
are going to start throwing shit away at the dump, too. I know. Can't get down there because it's muddy. Well, we got quite a bit out of wood out of there. So next week when we go down there, it'll probably be more wood down there. You don't do this anymore. I'm gonna hire a wife to decorate our home. So you feel more at ease here. You don't need to roam. Take out the dining room table. Put a bar along that wall. And a neon sign to point the way to our bathroom down the hall. Insulation in the boxes, and all that. Yeah, we need another roll of insulation so we can take out that old. I'm hoping that we will. Insulation, I think they do hold in the back, I think. I was going to, but I didn't feel like going anywhere when I got home last night. Really. I didn't feel like going over Tony's either, but his sister died Friday morning, so. Where are my keys? No. Yeah, his sister was only 54 years old.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, liver cancer. All right, where's the outlets? Roy. They got steel ones here. They have a metal one somewhere, don't they? Or the plastic ones? I mean, where the hell did I see the plastic ones before? You have the steel ones there. I thought we needed... Yeah, plastic ones are over here. You going to need any of that? What about when... that's for conduit there? What about for... Like junction box when you splice the wires together.
Did you need any?
Yeah, because the one's going to go along that wall where the closet used to be. Well, that and then, we already got one up top there where that light switch is, that back bar piece there. There's already one there, and all that's going to go there. But it's that wall, so we would need one of them. But we have one already, don't we? Yeah, and we got the cover to it. The square one. Yeah, we need. Wow, we needed what? Six? I think we need six. Six regular ones for the outlets. One for the white, one for the light switch.
Four of them. Those are 79 apiece. Grab four of them.
See, we have six sheets of sheetrock. Whoops. Yeah. Yeah, so this will be enough from now until we... Well, then I can stop by Home Depot sometime this week and get some more. The junction bars where we... Got to go where the closet on the wall, where the closet used to be, the bathroom wall and the bedroom wall, that wall there.
Yeah.
because they don't want to put two outlets on there. So you'd have to splice it from the outer wall to go onto that wall. I think so too. What about a cover for it? You need a cover for it? One of these? Coop. I'm not sure if they have outlets. Outlets, white outlets.
10 pack?
Yeah. 650. Yeah, that would be a better buy. Let's see what they have for switches here. They won't. Jesus. I'm a fucking expensive. I'm like $18-$19 left. Yeah. Oh, that's a three different ones. Let's see, we only need one under there. Brian. Oh, no kidding. Huh. Oh, shit. Well, be goddamn, I never fucking seen them before. And his one was a little dimmer. Well, those are expensive here, aren't they?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I didn't think those would be that expensive. Well, expensive here anyway, so. Let's get them at Home Depot. See if they get at Home Depot. I'd get a better buy. Insulation. Oh, God, yeah. Yeah, we got all kinds of wire nuts and electrical tape. Yeah, I think just insulation now. Oh, you get them. Yeah, it's been heavy or slippery. How are we doing? Hit some more.
Oh, the propane. That's it. I get 200.
Oh, do you have insulation here?
Insulation?
Yeah.
Like wall insulation?
Yeah. No. Oh, you don't? No. Crap. Thought you did. I'll have to steal some from the shed. Yeah, please. Yeah, make it easy for you. Thank you. You too. If you want. Oops. Not now, it's unlocked now. forget to put that in my home file. Yeah,
I get back, I go out and shop, bring them all in, drink a beer, and it could be built on.
I keep forgetting I'm in here, that I wind up not going through them, and then screw myself doing that.
Jackie's vehicle.
Yeah, I don't. Her mind floats in other places. Oh, shit. I probably should have gotten gas right now. But I didn't get it later on. I'm so in love with you, I'm in love with Harriet. We'd never part, oh hello Mary Lou, goodbye heart. I wonder if they're giving that washer away. Ken, why? We need... Guess we shouldn't have taken this fucking back way. Potholes. Yeah, yeah. Hello, Mary Lou. Dubai heart. Really, silver jingle, and you must have known the words to at least a million tunes. But the one most interesting, man, you know this cowboy, from the mountain, the big sun, and we all come back to the moon. It's up on here.
Okay, bye.
Why are you saying bye?
Because this music is shit.
Hey, this music is good shit.
It smells like Roy's underwear.
Yeah, you hear Roy? When he says this music smells like your underwear.
Hey, I changed my underwear. It's a bunch
of weather.
Easy
to know. Yeah.
He wants me to wear a thong.
Did he change? Okay. He said he changes his underwear once a month, whether it needs it or not.
Oh, wow. That's attractive.
She said, that's attractive. Sounds like a shitty situation.
Wow, that sounds like a great song. Thought Crime!
Thought Crime! Is Debbie there yet?
No.
Why the hell did she leave her phone behind?
Because she's just so cool.
Well, what's cool about that?
Because she don't give a fuck. Not a fuck, not a single solitary fuck.
Yeah, I guess not.
Okay, bye.
Oh, whatever. Jeez.
in the long boat twist. Hey, hurry up. Let's go. Stop, drop. Towel's blowing down there. Oh, shoot. What are you doing, honey?
Bot crossing.
Where's Victor?
I don't know. Where's your mom? Nah.
Actually, she's in the house.
Well, go get her ass out and tell her you're going to take her for breakfast, eh?
No, Roy already fed her breakfast.
What do you feed her?
I don't know. He probably made her... Hell, I don't know. I didn't ask him this morning. No, she got sausages from yesterday. He made her.
Skin on?
No, he probably made her an English muffin or something. Stop that. He's talking about my mom. No, stop it. Winnie, show respect for my mom.
Your lady, old lady, old lady.
Show respect for my mom.
Oh, I was yodeling, a yokel. You should know what that is, right?
Yodel. Oh. Well, what you were asking me before...
Was that supposed to be impressive?
No. What you were asking me before was put your finger on your windpipe. Okay, not hard. Just gentle. Gentle.
I can't.
Listen,
I have
to me. Not hard. I didn't say choke you, so hang on. Mom's coming out. Hang on. Don't say anything so I can hear her.
Penis.
You did. No, we went down Quinn's. Then Roy forgot to get something. So he had to come back so he could get something. I don't know what it was. So I thought you were going to be gone already.
Huh?
I thought you were going to be gone already.
Be gone.
Yeah, I thought you were going to play cards. Oh. Like being outside now, don't you? Nice out here. Well, except for the clouds. At least the wind's not cold, though. It's good. It's good that you like... So, well, I think that's a good idea. You need to start doing them again. I know. You're starting to smell like one, too. Okay, I'm back. Mom went inside. Wind's a little bit chilly for her. Okay, you listening to me? Baby? Hello? Hello, hello, hello? Houston, we have a problem. Hello, hello, hello? 1A. 1A.